So we're back, and now I'm going to show you something. The first thing we're going to show you is what you can see when playing. So, without further ado, let's get started on that. Now, you can clearly see this screen here is still present, but something else I want to show you is not related to anything from previous updates. Hopefully it should show in a few seconds. Yep, there's the weapons, and as you can see, I'm wearing uniform. Before they don't wear that today. Now, there's more that I want to show you, but we'll have to wait and see if it really happens. So I'll be right back when the team thing comes back up. Urban can be man-made structures, including the safe houses and oil rig arena. So the original force, when you play the specific level, as you can see, this is the block source. Right, they're still wearing the same. Turn this up a bit so you can hear me. I don't expect you to, but still. I'm going to make it better for you so you can understand what's going on. But that was the urban uniform. The other people were wearing the, forest version of their uniform, which was also urban. Now, we are going to continue playing this until we hit Fort Celsius. And when we hit Fort Celsius, I'm going to show you exactly, hold it for a minute, exactly what it is. It's important to know that. It's part of the update. Like everything was intended. Alright. So, there's the weapons and everything. I'm going to tell my comrades to push, since I am squad leader. Wow, that was quick. That's our first victory. Yeah, that does happen. Now, we might go into some of these issues in a minute, or actually, towards the end of the video. But for right now, we're only focusing on what's in the present and the closest part of the past you can find. So just keep that in mind throughout the whole video. Okay, so I see the Polizei. Okay, this is another one I want to show you. And to prove the point of earlier, we are going to grab one of these weapons here. I'm going to grab the UMP-40, and the pistol, I'll grab the USP-40. Why is that important? Well, I'm not sure. things have changed, and I want to make sure people know that they have. But as time goes by, not faster. Wow, that was quick. Another issue we need to cover. Towards the end. That's another one that you just heard. It does get annoying, but still. I mean, it could be worse. The reason why most of the enemies and everybody else are killed at the end is because when we try to just delete them, it doesn't necessarily work properly. This happened before. Like, I'm not joking. And if it was actually, you know, let's just say normal for us to do that, it wouldn't break anything. Yeah. So, with that being said, we have to take this step by step. Hopefully, next year, more bugs will be eliminated. Oh, by the way, did you see this here? Okay, and to make things better, you can clearly see that, right? That's green. So the actual color is. Usually this is something. Which you've seen before. This is like a black. It's basically like the trenches in World War One. The flow of the gameplay. The level design is just like that. Harsh. And as we know from self-improvement channels like Hamza and all those others, it took masculine men to fight in that war, not someone feminine. Because let's be honest, like, you wouldn't go straight out of the trench to face your enemy if you were the other way around that I just described. Because if you were, well, you wouldn't be able to face it. You'd be afraid. It literally takes a lot of courage to actually do that on this map. Because they're basically like the trenches. The minute you step onto the bridge, you're definitely going to be killed if you're not looking for another aspect that I appreciate about this game is the fact that it does have its tough sides, you know, sides of a game that make it particularly difficult to play, but not in a horrible way, you know, like unplayable or something like that. It's supposed to be hard, not easy. Like, if everything was easy, then you'd, like, be able to win some. Even though I was supposed to, like, cross the bridge and stuff. And it always happens. Anyways, let's just see if we can get to Fort Celsius. If not, I'll pause the video footage and see if I can force our way in there. So, let's just see what happens right now. In the moment. Okay. Is it going to show us? Alright, I'll choose these guys. Oh, just in time. So this is what I really wanted to show you guys, like, towards the end of this section, which was Fort Celsius. And as you can see, it's a different map. It's an alpine map. For the first time ever, we have an actual alpine map. Let's get started. So, first thing we're going to notice, if we are properly doing this, is that we are in actual mountainous uniforms. So, let's just tell everybody to push. Usually when it rains, got us. But at least you got to see the map, and you still get to see the snow, and also, as you may know, the uniforms. So, what did we learn from this segment? Well, for starters, the game now takes the climate system quite seriously. Uniforms change per climate. Alpine is now a thing. So it's not just one or two types of climates. It's all three. And we can also see that we did a good job on it. Even the text now reflects that. There was a time when that text never did that. And that was before this update. Anyways, I'll be right back for part two. Stand by. Okay guys, I'm back for part two, and this time we don't actually play the game here. We are going to this section. Now there are a few things I want to go over before we get into the rest. And to do that, I just had to bring up the changelog that will be submitted on our Discord, as in me and TPL, of course, as well as the unlockable system itself. Now, what do we have here? We have, let's see, 6 new weapons in phases 2, 3, and 4, a new map. We have a few changes that you can see that are pretty important, and let's go over those. So, the weapons. The first weapon is the 51A2, or HK51A2. It is a carbine chambered in 7.62 NATO. You heard me right. 7.62 NATO. Now you're wondering, isn't that unwieldy in the game? You'd be correct. Only the G3 can handle this properly, without necessarily going through the roof. This weapon, however, you really gotta put it on semi-auto. Because if you don't, it will get worse. What's even worse, however, with recoil, is the 51A3 and 51K. The 51A3 is a sliding stock version of this gun here, and it fires the same cartridge. Use this with caution. If you want to go full auto a little bit, always extend the stock, no matter what. Because this weapon, you can't do any of that. The 51K is like the MP5K, but its recoil is way higher. To the point where you know for sure that it's too high to even use in auto, only single shot. Now, the 52A2 is like the 51, but, excuse me, instead of 7.62 NATO, it's another 7.62. M43, aka 7.62 Soviet. And what is that? 7.62x39. The same bullet found in the AK-47. Not just in this game, but, well, in any AK that fires it. And as you can see, you can tell that it's that because of this curved magazine. And if I press unlock, what you see there is a curve like this. What does that curve mean? Well, the round is tapered. This is what I've learned so far from reading and other people's sources. The round is tapered in a way that makes the magazine have to use a curve to keep all the rounds in place. Otherwise, it'd be a problem. This one's straighter because the round is different in how it works. Like, there's not really much of a taper on this one, but there is on this one, which I don't understand yet, but I will in the future. And one day in another devlog, I'll tell you about it. Now, this gun is like that, but it's different. It uses this mag, and it's basically an M43. Same with this for this. Alright. Now, as you've seen before, there was a new map, Fort Celsius. Alright, that was the new map. I'm also going to have to use my list that I made earlier of things to do to show you that we weren't kidding about phases 2, 3, and 4. Alright, so let's see. We did Fort Celsius. We also got some things working. So, the deploy screen now shows climate accurately. Of course, we saw that earlier in the first part. Snow falls instead of rain on Alpine maps. We saw that in the first part. And Smithery, if you didn't know, does respect this particular feature, which is the climate system. It has to. Otherwise, what are we doing? Now, the HK50. That's what that other one was, this stuff here, that we saw in the unlockables. Another thing you did not see, and you might not be able to, because if you look here, you can find it. Hold on, it should be up here. Just gotta look hard enough to find it. Let me go down a little bit. Okay, there it is. See this weapon here? This is the M4957. Now, what makes it so important? We did some maintenance on it. It was soundless. So we fixed the problem. Now it works. That is all we have for this particular side of this part. Now, I am going to have to get this ready for the next part, because it's in two modes. You'll see. Anyways, I'll be right back. Hello everyone. We're back again. So now as you can see, we are in a different mode. And I'm going to just pick the Bloxers. Now how you can tell we're in a different mode? Very simple. See this? This is the spawns. You do not see this in Lifeline being usable ever. Because, well, we haven't gotten there yet if we were. And two, it wouldn't be useful when you have a squad. Yeah, a squad. So, let's get started. Although we might be able to implement this maybe once. But only in like a certain group of spawns or something. Anyways, this is not what we're talking about, or that was not what we're supposed to be focused on. What we're supposed to be focused on, specifically, is something I like to call GRP. What does it stand for? Gratitude, Reflection, Prediction. So, we're going to do the past first, gratitude. Present is reflection, and prediction obviously is the future. This happens every year from now on. If we're still working on a game, yes, we will do that every year that's being developed at the end. Let's get started. One thing I'm definitely grateful for is that the RW map out saw an opportunity one time to do it. I did it. Some people only dream of this. We got lucky. Right? Now, I'm gonna show you something else I'm working for. That happened actually this year. We got an upgrade this year. As you can see, the destruction system got overhauled. Normally, that stuff would go straight in the air, like could be exaggerated. However, we knew for sure we had to fix this. Why? It looked quite crappy in the beginning, as you can see. However, if you look at that, that is way more accurate in terms of destruction than we had before. And it actually replicates now, this time. Because if it didn't replicate, you'd know. You wouldn't be able to go through it. See, AI had lots of trouble in my flying going through it. Like, the whole works. And that's something I'm grateful for, that it works now, compared to before. If I didn't take action on that, it would still be in the same state, and it wouldn't be as good for Nemesis Hunt or anything else. Which it is used in Nemesis Hunt. You do have to blow up a door in the temple in Hunter's Valley to actually get through and get to the next checkpoint. Now the next piece of gratitude, excuse me, is right here. Right in front of you. Watch and observe. Now, when we go up the elevator, we're going to talk about it. Itself, but also the actual interaction system. I remember last year, around May, there was something wrong with those interactions. It wasn't as structured well as it used to be. Like, there was a lot of problems with lag and stuff like that. You remember that by using, you guessed it. If you didn't see it before, you see it now. Proximity prompts, internally, to make it work. I'm grateful that the technology is actually compatible with the way we handle interactions and the user interface you just saw that handled the interaction. Because that could have been much worse. Think about it. There was a time when this wasn't even thought of, where you couldn't see the timing because, well, there was no holding, there was no, first of all, there was no holding-based interactions. Everything was press and you're done. Now you can actually hold a button to interact and it works seamlessly. Thanks, Roblox. It's the first time I'm going to say that. Thank you, Roblox. Another thing I'm going to be grateful for is this. Hold on. I'll get it better. In fact, you know what? Let's reset. I know how to solve that issue. Yeah. So we're going to actually have to go to one of these. Oh yeah, I'll do that. And that. Perfect. That we're able to put the grip recall on this That is an infrared laser. It's the dot of an infrared laser. To put it into more context, let me show you how it works. Yes! Got it right. It does actually work. Depending on where you're aiming. Like it's supposed to. Now granted, the sight could be better in terms of the handling of the rim. It's far from perfect. Is to make a point about a specific type of system or attachment. There was a time, by the way, when this system was not going to be in the game. Alright? This system was going to be completely erased. Why was it being erased? Let me tell you why it was being erased. Other lasers. This one has this particular trait that is special. You can only see it, mind you, if you have night vision. If you don't, you won't be able to see it. Anyways, let's get to the next piece of gratitude. As you saw before, I did a reload animation. Notice what you saw there. That was a few camera shake instances. Now this could have been worse. Let me be honest, it could have been much worse, and I've seen worse with this. We've been resisting the urge to put camera shake in the game for a long time, specifically for at least 3 years. Almost 2 years. Because we did start early. That's a good thing. It could have been worse. Now, another thing I'm grateful for. Walk up here. Granted, that wasn't the best instance. But as you can see, I was able to climb that. Yes, I'm quite grateful that that was actually doable. Because there was a time when I guess climbing was not in the game. That was in the game initially. The character and the system that we started with this was a little bit different. Or that we used to start this was a little bit different. However, I will tell you this. This system could have been much worse if we had focused on climbing at the time, procedurally. Let's be honest. You know how the technology worked regarding climbing. Luckily this time, we got to see it in action, we got to figure out what we did wrong with the failures, and use that to make a better system that actually allows you to climb the ladder and get to the top. And now it works. So basically what I'm saying is that we had to remove climbing and fail at making a replacement to get it back in the game. That was not easy by any means. And, yeah, pretty much. So if we go to loadout, do we go to loadout for this? Yeah. We're going to unlockables, actually, not loadout. You can use unlockables anywhere, but loadout you can only use if you select it in the menu. Now this, as you can see, is the QP system. However, look on the bright side. This isn't just any old progression system. This thing allows the grind to feel less painful, and does take some of it out. Like, you don't have to grind for a single weapon extensively that you can unlock from here freely, because it's usually low costing in terms of QPs. The highest amount of QPs that you can use to buy anything on this specific user interface is 7 QPs. That's the highest. No other numbers has gone higher than that regarding QP amounts, like actual amounts. And if you look down here, let's just say you wanted the G3A3. 3 QPs, it's a battle rifle. It uses the same round as snipers that use it. This is a sniper rifle. It's 5 QPs, but still, it's not even that bad. It's not even close to 7. It's off by 2 QPs. This is a DMR. This is 3. What else is there? You got the SETME 58. That's 3 QPs. The point is almost proven, but I'm going to prove it even more so. That's 4. That's the M60. Yes. Most of this stuff is pretty good. In other words, yes, it could have been much worse where the prices were double. And if the prices were double, that would have caused a lot of problems. It would have taken away from my mission to save the games industry by making games better and less, let's just say, demanding on players. In other words, we want players to not have a problem with being able to live their own life and still play this game, but in a limited fashion. What I mean by that is the game is in a limited fashion, not the players. Alright? So, yeah, I mean, it could have been worse. But luckily, it got better. Alright? Because of this choice here that I made in 2019, it got better. And look, there's a lot of stuff here. We even got this working. We had this planned in 2019. However, with the system before this one that was used, it wasn't really efficient. It even allowed this to even be a thing. So we got lucky there. Another thing I'm grateful for in that realm, yeah, it's traits. Now you may think I'm a little bit nuts regarding traits, but let's be honest, there are worse things out there, you know? That don't even do justice to the game, like Call of Duty's perks. Take that for instance. Call of Duty's perks aren't even that great. They make the game less realistic, less tactical. Traits are the more tactical versions of perks. Like, they actually are based on what the character has, and not what they don't really have in that specific moment. Now, we do have attributes, but the attributes work with what you can improve, not what you cannot improve at all. Like, sleight of hand, yes, it's a dexterity type of thing, but it can be easily done with improvement over time, not this instant, you know, sleight of hand. You can't get sleight of hand that quickly. You have to unlock it with QPs over time with attributes, just like that. Another thing I'm grateful for. Achievements. Yes. these achievements. This could have been so much worse. Like, there was a time where we were considering what to do with this. But if this wasn't in the game, I don't think the reward weapons would exist. Because there wouldn't be any way to cover them. I'm going to show you. That was one of them. As you can see, this has the FLD-91. You destroy two tanks with it to get the FLD. This is for the SLF-93. That one, this one, this one, and this one. Basically, it's a chained reward. Complete all those challenges, you get it. Now, this is the M31/91, even though I have to fix the weapon, which we'll do next year. It still stands as you need to earn that weapon with this achievement, the M1D. Another thing I'm grateful for. You see this here? Now last night, the sound was a little different. It was at 2%. Now, I can turn this down right here, right? Or go back up here. Either way, it will save itself now. Because let me tell you something, it was much worse of a situation regarding this earlier this year before it got changed in January. Basically, I noticed while I was listening to Extraction Point by Hans Zimmer on Spotify that this could not save at all. That we were just sitting there doing nothing with it. That's horrible. People want to be able to save their volume so they never have to come back to it again and get annoyed by the same volume level. It's controllable. This is a lesson I learned while watching Big Fire TV years ago, but almost never applied properly. Now it's done like that, we have no worries about it. As you can see, we also have this here, which I'm also grateful for. The fact that we can disable certain features if needed, like blood, bullet whizzing. You can also toggle certain other features like surrender on reset and lifeline. Which, by the way, actually makes you surrender instead of killing you off, which makes more sense. Depth of field is also here. Camera sensitivity works. You also have this. You can even toggle the HUD and the chat off and on if you need to for more cinematic feel. We had this plan too, but in a keybind form. Now we don't need that keybind. All we need is this. Alright. Oh, and another thing I'm grateful for, if we go back to options again, is mobile controls. Yeah, mobile actually exists regarding this game. However, I do not suggest playing it right now because we have to figure out a way to keep it from lagging on my device and other people's devices in turn. Luckily, I do have an idea. We'll go into that in the new year. Alright. So, keep that in mind. Okay, let's go to loadout. Let's change our infantry or units to breach. I'm going to go to the M4 Super 90 and customize. Now, as you can see, this is a shotgun, right? It should be. However, I want to try out magazines and ammo. Let's see about that. You can choose buckshot. You can choose Brennecke. Choose birdshot. You can choose any of these ammunition types here, even Sabo. And best of all, if you need to add an extra round, like we did in the first phase, we added ghost loading. So basically, it opens this bolt up here, you add a shell into the chamber, and then you push it back when you're ready to load it into the gun. Perfect. Now, what about optics? You have this, you have this, you have that. I mean, what could go wrong? I mean, many things could go wrong. However, what we want you to know is that I'm grateful that this can actually do so much regarding customization in those areas that it can do. In fact, I'll show you another one. So if we go to furnitures, there's none there. If we go to alloys, look at that. Now you have a change that works. It's not that hard to deal with. In other words, it could have been much worse. Because there was a time where furnitures and alloys were just not the way they were supposed to be. They weren't tactical. They weren't real. Like, it was all textures and stuff. That's not good. Okay, unless it's real. In my eyes. Because then you're fooling the player into thinking, it's all cushy-cushy. It's all, let's just say, you get, you know, flaming unicorns and things that really don't make sense in a video game like this. So yes, we have everything to be grateful for. Heck, there's even vehicles in this game. Anyways, guys, we'll get into the next section of this section in a minute. Alright, I'm going to take a small break and we'll come back for the next part. See you there. Welcome back. Now on to the next part of this section. Reflection. So, what could we do better? Well, one thing you just saw. You guessed it. There is an issue with the spawn thing being out like that in Lifeline. It should only be used if there's like certain spawns you can pick. We call them spawn picks. But that might happen next year. You never know. Alright. Another thing that I wish we could do better. Some of the weapons in this specific system may not be that visible. That could have been done better from the start. Alright, now I think we're on Oil Rig Arena. Another thing we could have done better is covering more squad layouts. To be honest, there's more units that we have than you think. Some of them are not even covered in text like this, like they should be. So I'm going to try Soviet 2. And we're going to do Outcast. UMP-40, I'll do the Type 100. Another thing we could have done better is the depiction of some maps. Like, Rotskin Sea is definitely going to need a better aura and, you know, image or whatnot. Instead of just being stagnant and not even able to be used. Because that does concern me. Another should be noted is that I do want to do something like this better regarding, the game isn't fair, like Ackman said. It is fun. It has to be something well, even as a tactical shooter, to be able to do things. Like, there shouldn't be any unnecessary, you know, overpowered units or whatnot. Yikes. I did not see that one coming. Another thing we could have done better is the sound design the handling of the sound design regarding the end of round when the player is defeated. We should keep that silent. It should never have a sound to it. We initially planned this, but we fell through in some areas. However, we cannot fix it right now because it's the end of the year, and as you are hearing right now, this is the Devlog that caps it out. Now, what else could we have done better? Hold on, wait for it. Wait for it. This is Hunter's Valley. Okay, so let's try something else. Maybe a carbine. That'll do. Okay, as you can see, this is Hunter's Valley. For the noobs to just jump into a fight and not know what to do. But anything's possible, right? As you can see here, this is urban and we are on a different map. Huh? Another thing I could have done better is the better and more efficient usage of terrain regarding grass. Now, don't get me wrong, grass is pretty good for this map, especially if you're going hunting, as in sniping. You want to be hidden from view. However, thing we could have done better, and probably earlier, is variants of lifeline. Why is this? See, this is pretty basic. Even though it doesn't work, it could have been much better. Yeah, it could have been. I got defeated again. But no worries, though. We still got the point across of what we could have done better here. I'll go into more stuff as we get through two more maps. Yes, in two more maps, and then we're going to go over the predictions. So, let's just sit back, enjoy the ride for now. Once we get there, we're getting into some serious stuff. So, Hunter's Valley could have also been done better. Like, some elements of Hunter's Valley weren't that great. Some others were better, as you can see, and if we had done that better, I think things would have been, you know, way easier. Now, another thing I want to go into when we spawn, I'm going to show you this. For right now, so the next thing we're going to go over that I could have done better. Wait for it. Actually, you guessed it. Keeping your guard up regarding this weapon and others like it. In other words, you could have handled this weapon better in our soccer type of team, not just in 2021, but 2022. As you may know, there was a recent change to CSG, if you've kept up with the dev forum. How does that pose a problem, you ask? Well, that change messed up some of the parts. The sooner we go over our predictions, the sooner we can end this. So, I think, if I'm not mistaken, we are 33 minutes in. We should be able to end it in the next, let's just say, 5 to 10 after the last map, which is whatever's coming up right now. Oh, wow, Fort Celsius. That's a nice touch. So let's see. That reminds me, too. There's another thing I think we could have done better. Not just from 2021's end around this time, but also from 2022's start. Actually, we can do this. The song here could be done better. I mean, granted, I did my best to make this work, but as you can hear, it still has its issues, still has its faults. We can't go back and spoil it forever because that album is technically finished. It is expected to be released officially, though, in the next 2 days. We jump into this, you can clearly see that this map is a snow map. I'm glad we did this. It's also better than... Yikes, I don't think we did that right. Anyways, one thing I wish we could have done better is, well, the outfits from the start. You know, if we had this better in terms of how we handled every single Alpine, Urban, and Forest outfit that wasn't in the game, I think we would have not had so many bugs to fix, and this video would have been done sooner. However, it is noted that the tanks is something I wish was better as well. See, tank battle was started in 2021, late 2021, and I do regret not maintaining it as good as I should have, because, well, it was promising. It was very much so promising. However, there were serious issues with it. Not just, you know, glitches regarding getting into the tanks, but also using them sometimes. And I feel that messed up the flow of the gameplay a bit, which is not good. Anyways, those are the things I wish I could have done better. I'll be back for the next part, which will be the predictions. Stand by. Alright guys, we're staying in Lifeline for this one. This is the last segment of this section. Predictions. So, we're only going to play about two maps from this point, and within 5 minutes we will go over what we could do in 2023, or what will be done, rather, in 2023. From a summarized point of view. Anyways, let's get started. The first thing we're going to definitely work on is the improvement of artificial intelligence and many other elements of Lifeline. Why? Next year we're also working on the campaign. We're not just talking about one campaign, we're talking about multiple campaigns. You want the best for every side. Now, the next thing we want to fix... Yeah, you just guessed it. The campaign. I mean, the tank battle. As you can see, tank battle doesn't really work that well. It has some issues that are pretty glaring. Another thing we're going to work on is bugs. Bug fixes. More bug fixes this time. Okay, less complacency, more fixing of the bugs. I mean, there were so many good things that happened, but there's also some things that fell short, like I described in the last section. And I want to improve that. Also, another thing that we are going to work on next year is more server options. I mean, custom servers. Now, if you don't know what those are, basically, you can start your own little server or gameplay session in this game, we're going multiplayer, that allows you to, you know, do it the way you want it to be done. That's the mission of that. However, we are lacking some of the properties needed to make that happen. Alright. And I feel like next year is a great time to fix that. Because to be honest, it could have been worse, but it could be better. And just letting things slide just because you want to is not a good thing. Alright, do what you have to do, not what you don't want to do, necessarily. I mean, do what you want to do, but do it in a way that helps you in the future, not just in the moment. Another way to is the variance as a whole, and also the Rods Can See map. Right now, Rods Can See, no, is quarantined. And yes, this weapon is having some issues with animations. We'll also work on that next year as well. Everything. So, I mean, yeah, I brought this on myself regarding tank battle. And as a promise to you guys next year, I will make sure, at least once in the year, or maybe twice depending on what I have to do, that I will fix that problem and end it before it gets worse. No later than August of 2023. So, we went over a lot. Now, let's close out the video. Still in game though. Alright, so we're back. To sum this up, we did what we had to do with the December update and with the year as a whole. We're grateful for many things that made the game better and not worse, but we also recognize the bad things, and even show it off in this particular devlog. It's not all, you know, roses and unicorns. There are some things that I really need to work on, not just personally, but also from this work standpoint too. And we made our predictions. We will fix a lot of things, including mobile. But not right now. Right now is the time to take that in, what we did, reflect on it, figure out what we can do better, write it down on paper eventually, and start the new year off strong. Anyways, the next devlog will be on January 2nd, 2023. Mm-hmm. But it won't be in-game, like this one was. It will be in a PowerPoint. That's how we usually started this off from now on. We did that with the December update. So, with that being said, my name's Erdos12. I'll see you next time. Happy holidays to all. And to all, a good afternoon. Bye.